humanitarian, and then I went back and decided to use my MFA. So I wrote the character-driven novel, The Shores of Our Souls. It was my third novel, and the first one to get a publisher, and it was published August 2017 by Touchpoint Press. And today, I'm going to talk to you a little bit about the inspiration behind why I wrote this novel. Let me tell you a story, because we humans are full of stories. And we writers have it in our DNA. We're composed of stories. Abiba was a wonderful friend and colleague. We started a unique tracing program to connect Somalis in Somalia with refugees here. She wouldn't have said that she was responsible for it because she was too humble, but she was. She invited me to ride with her and a colleague Ali one day to go search for Somali young men. Taxi stand to taxi stand. We met a lot of young men that day. They talked about burying their dead quickly, which was against Somali custom. They talked about trudging miles without food or water toward the Kenyan border when they were just young teens. They described the journey to the States, sometimes with multiple stops. They talked about not knowing where their family members were and afraid to really ask before they started to apply for American citizenship. They were afraid to even tell me their first names, but they told me their stories. I heard about the military taking away sibling after sibling. I heard about how one had seen his older brother shot by a member of the military, and then he hesitated and said, or was it a looter? He still didn't know. From June to September of 93, Abiba and Ali found 50 men residing in the United States that they reconnected with their families in Somalia, their families who had considered them lost forever. They taught me about the value of connection, of being part of the global family. Tell you another story. Majid Samarghandi came from Iran to study engineering at the University of Chicago. He has his doctorate in construction management, and he's owner of an award-winning construction company in Cincinnati. He teaches business ethics at the University of Cincinnati. He's a father, and he's a husband, and he's a member of the Baha'i Faith. The Baha'i Faith teaches tolerance for all, unity and equality for all, and helping others without expectation. Majid became a citizen in 1985, and he is the eternal optimist. But he's faced a lot of discrimination. From the pizza delivery guy who knocked on his door and when he answered wouldn't give him his pizza because he was Arab, to real physical threats walking alone in cities. Here's what he says. Americans are wonderful people. One enemy is too many. You can never have enough friends. My faith teaches me to ask what I can do in the minutest way to bring a smile to someone's face, happiness to a broken heart. Yet he knows we can't ignore prejudice. So he and his wife started a second Saturday meeting where they invite the neighborhood and the neighborhoods beyond of all backgrounds to join for discussion. They meet every month, and it's working. This is in Cincinnati. When I asked him a little further question, because he's an old friend of mine, he said, you can't paint through the rust because it'll just come back. You've got to find a solution. Majid and his wife are a lesson in walking your talk and putting ideas into action. One more. Randy spent the first part of his life in an addiction-riddled family. He thought he'd broken free until 6,000 people in his community of Waterloo, Iowa, abandoned their homes, put their keys on the mantles for the mortgage companies to come collect. That's when he started using. Randy was Waterloo's first AIDS case. He told me about the bullying his daughter faced in school, about not being able to invite old friends over to his home, about the woman who cursed at him for accidentally touching an object in her house. Randy joined and then started to lead an AIDS support group. I've always bitched about how nobody jumps in to help, so I jumped in myself. I figure I got a good year in me. Randy led the support group for 9 more months. I read the story I wrote about him at his funeral. Today, people are more accepting of people with AIDS. Things go in cycles. And now, his style of support groups have spread throughout the world. Randy taught me about legacy.